Construction on the Rosemont mine has been debated for years now. There are a lot of residents that say it will simply destroy their quality of life, but supporters say it'll create jobs and provide a much needed boost to the economy. Now a state senator is taking some major heat for writing a letter supporting the construction of the mine. Nine on Your Side's Sergio Avila has more on the fallout.
Just 2 days ago, Senate President Bob Burns and House Speaker Kirk Adams co-wrote a letter saying the Rosemont project was, quote, a tremendous opportunity for Southern Arizona. The letter also said it was written on behalf of the Arizona Senate and House of Representatives. But now he's retracting those statements. Our local lawmakers were left in the dark and didn't appreciate what happened.
They shouldn't have done it this way. They just cut us out of the loop completely. And to me, that's an example of Maricopa County just not thinking about the rest of the state.
Both Republicans and Democrats were shocked a letter would be written on their behalf without being consulted first.
They don't seem to understand it because there's Republicans and Democrats alike who don't want this mine.
Senator John Payton was the first to act aggressively and was named in Senator Bob Burns's retraction. In it, he writes, talking about Payton, we understand his consistent opposition to the plan, and although we support mining, we do not want the February 2nd letter to be understood as an endorsement of the Rosemont plan. However, Senator Burns' letter does represent the thoughts of some Vail residents.
I happen to think it's a good idea. It creates jobs, helps the housing markets because all employees got to, you know, have a place to live. So I think it's great for Vail and the area.
Other folks in Vail who live closer to where the mine would be call Senator Burns' actions appalling.
If you're going to be in an elected position, that you certainly need to listen to your constituents.
Sergio Avila, KGUN 9, on Your Side.
Now, we did try to contact both Senator Bob Burns and House Speaker Kirk Adams, but we never heard back from them today. We also tried to get a hold of local Republicans, including Frank Antonori and Vic Williams, but our calls were not returned. Antonori has already been quoted as saying that Burns should have put a resolution forward requesting the legislators' opinion on the mine project before sending out that letter.